The parsha begins in Truma with two commandments that are certainly related. On the surface, are not striking, but when you think about it a little bit more deeply, are actually somewhat problematic. Go and speak to Bnei Israel, and you should take donations. You have to take zahav, kesef, and nechoshes, all of the different items that you may need. Why are you taking them? You're going to create for me a mikdash, a sanctuary, a place for me to dwell, so that I may dwell amongst the people. And it makes a lot of sense. In order to have the mikdash, you need to have the people donate. But if you think about it, logically, we would have thought that the tzivuyim, the commandments, would be in the opposite order. First, make for me a mikdash. Then we know what the target is. After there's a commandment to build a mikdash, so then tell Klal Yisrael, I'm asking you to give. Everybody should give. Everybody should give from what is precious. Everybody should give what is dear. But whatever they may have, you should take something and give it for the purpose of this mikdash. But then the target would already exist. Like this, it seems strange. First, you're saying, take. What are we taking for? What do we have to give for? Oh, v'asuli mikdash v'shachanti b'socham. The reason that you're obligating, or asking you to give, is for the purpose of the mikdash. So why would the Torah write in that order, instead of beginning with the commandment to build a mikdash and follow it with, now that you have to build a mikdash, you should participate by donating to the project? I saw a fascinating insight. There's somewhere else in the Torah where we have something that is parallel. Hashem appears to Avram Avinu and tells him, Lech lecha me'artzecha u'mimoladetecha mi'beis avicha el'aretz asher areka. You should go from your land, from your birthplace, from your father's home, to the land that I will show you. And what does the Medrash say there? V'lo hodi ol neheichan yecho. He didn't tell them where you're going. You would think first, as I'm giving you the target, I'm giving you where to go. Why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu not first tell him where the target is and saying, now you should get up and you should go? And the Medrash says, Kedei litin lo schar al kol halicha v'halicha. To give him extra reward on each and every step of the journey. What does that mean? What are Chazal trying to teach us? What it seems to be is that if Hashem had already told Avraham Avinu to where he is going, then that becomes the target. That becomes the mitzvah. Everything else is just a process of making sure that we're going to get to that target. But there's no challenge in each step along the way. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted that every step should be a mitzvah. And the only way that every step is going to be a mitzvah and not just a hechsher mitzvah, not just a hechit mitzvah, not just a way of getting to the mitzvah, is by not telling him where it is that he's going. I am only going because HaKadosh Baruch Hu has told me to do it. And then the schar that you get is on every step along the way. In which case, it could be the same thing here as well. If first Hashem says, V'asuli mikdash v'shachanti b'socham, build for me a mikdash, and then I may dwell amongst you. So who is not going to clamor? Who is not going to want to give for that purpose? Instead, the Torah presents it as the reason to give is because I'm asking you to give. It doesn't matter why. In the end, I'll tell you that you're giving because V'asuli mikdash v'shachanti b'socham. But the giving is because, not because of the mikdash. The giving is because I commanded you to do it. There's a certain bittul. There's a certain nullification of our sense of self that is needed in our avodas Hashem. That when we turn to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we don't always know what the end result is going to be. But we serve Hashem because it is the right thing to do. We do mitzvot because they are the right things to do, because Hashem said to do them. And sometimes we will get the result, and sometimes we will see the destination, but other times we won't quite see how it is that we are going to get there. But we know, because we have been commanded to daven and to learn and to do mitzvot, that it is the right thing to do. How is it going to get there? We don't know how it's going to get there. But HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, if you go on the journey and do what I say, then I will later show you where that destination is. I will help bring you there. But we need the emunah. We need to have the strength of an Avraham Avinu. We need the strength of a Klal Yisrael, being willing to give, even before they know what the target is going to be, when we turn to HaKadosh Baruch Hu with our emunah pshuta, and we daven and we say, we don't know what the plan is, we don't know what the destination is, but we know we need you, We know we need your help and we turn to you because that's what's right. That's what you're asking us to do. And then hopefully soon HaKadosh Baruch Hu shows us that destination, that Yeshua, and that Geula, and that soon we will once again have that Beis HaMikdash V'asu LiMikdash, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu's Shechina will be felt in the strongest and most palpable way in this world.